It's 31 teams in 31 days. Matt Waymire alongside Dan Rosen. Our journey today takes us up to Toronto as we check out a Maple Leafs team back in the postseason for the first time in 4 years. And the biggest reason why, a dynamic offense from 28th to 5th this past season in goals scored, 250 on the nose. And I think this team back in the playoffs, maybe a year or two ahead of schedule.
Absolutely. Way ahead of schedule. No doubt about it. And a big reason for their being ahead of schedule was the success of this rookie class. They had the best rookie class in the league, led by Auston Matthews, who won the Calder Trophy. He was terrific. Better, I think, than anybody could have anticipated him being in his first year, even though he was the number one pick. Mitchell Marner was sensational. William Nylander the same way. Connor Brown and Zach Hyman were better than anybody could have imagined they'd be, maybe at any point in their career. And Nikita Zaitsev on defense was very good too. So they had a tremendous rookie class, and it was led by Mike Babcock, who to me, if he's not the best coach in the league, he's top two or three. What he was able to do last season in charting the path for this team with this amount of rookies to get them to the playoffs, one of his best coaching jobs ever.
No question. And they gave the Capitals a heck of a scare in round one before bowing in six games. But what a series that was. So, Dan, the rookies and the youngsters got the Maple Leafs this far, and I think some infusion of veteran talent could make this team take the next step.
Yeah, and I think that's what Lou Lamoriello and Mike Babcock and Brendan Shanahan were thinking here when they signed Patrick Marleau to a three-year contract. Marleau at 46 points last year, 27 goals with the San Jose Sharks, the only team he's known, but he is a veteran guy. He's been around. He's played in a lot of playoff games, and he was just recently, 2 years ago, in the Stanley Cup final. He knows what it's all about. That's only going to help guys like Matthews and Marner and Nylander. That's going to help them. Dominic Moore signs a one-year contract, returns to Toronto, a team he once played for before. He is going to take some pressure off of the centers because he's going to be a fourth-line center. But if you need a defensive zone faceoff, a guy to win that faceoff late in the game, that's going to be Dominic Moore. That takes pressure off of guys like Marner and Matthews and even Nazem Kadri as well. And Ron Hainsey, just coming off a Stanley Cup championship with the Pittsburgh Penguins, signs a two-year deal. He's another veteran on that D that has a young, it's a young D with Morgan Riley and Jake Gardner and Nikita Zaitsev. Ron Hainsey, a veteran presence there, and now a Stanley Cup champion.
Dan, not a newsflash here, but Toronto, the great city of Toronto, a hockey mad market. They are very excited about this dynamic, young Maple Leafs team, but now expectations in Toronto are going to be through the roof. The biggest question could be, can the youngsters handle this?
Well, that's the thing. It's about pressure now. It's about understanding that you have taken that step, a step that nobody really expected you to take yet. And how do you take the next step when the entire league understands what to expect, when the entire market is expecting you to do something special? Look, the book is out on Matthews and Marner and these guys. The league understands it. They know what to expect. They're going to take the Toronto Maple Leafs seriously. It's about adjustment now for the Leafs. At first, when they come into the league, these young players, you know, they get used to it, they get their feet wet, and they're doing things that nobody really has seen them do before because they haven't been there before. Then the league adjusts to you. The next step is you adjust back, you make some changes, and that's what this team is going to have to do. How do they handle that? How do they handle the pressure? How do they handle the expectations? That's going to be the key to their success this season.
Toronto's overall team defense last season, only bottom third in the NHL, even though the PK, surprisingly good, 10th in the league, 82.5%. But, Dan, defensive issues aside, I got to think that this Toronto team is going to be a playoff team again.
Yeah, I don't see them taking a step back. I don't think Mike Babcock will let them do that after they took what seemed like 100 steps forward last year. They will be a playoff team again. They will be better. They will be a contender.